My name is Kevin Cabral, and this is the story of my trip to Kenya. After a long journey from Florida to Dubai and Istanbul, I finally made it to Nairobi, Kenya, and then we took a plane to Mombasa, and finally we wound up right here in Kilifi, right on the coast, the Indian Ocean. Amazing place, wildlife everywhere. Monkeys on the beaches, monkeys running around the hotels, monkeys running around the airport. I knew it was looking good when I saw a rainbow the very first day. This is the house that I stayed in, right on the beach. And this is the beach in Kilifi. Beautiful white powdered sand beach. Heading up the path. This is an open area under the house and the pool area. Beautiful Saracenic arches. Very common in the area, more common than the typical round arch. Everywhere African handcrafts, beautiful artwork. These are my guards. And this is our breakfast every morning. Our guards are Maasai, and they stay on the grounds of the property. They sleep outside, and they watch over us every night. Here we are on a local handmade dhow, cruising up the Kilifi River. Very tropical, mangroves everywhere. You'll see these dugout canoes. Looks like this guy has cleverly put a patch over a leaky area on his canoe. They'll row out into the mangroves and collect some dead wood to use to turn into charcoal and use for cooking fires. This is an unusual house, built in a more of a Swiss style. Typical bird life in the mangroves. White heron. This is a yellow-billed stork. Some hawks. Another white heron. Are with our friends on the dhow, and they're doing a little hand lining.
Yeah.
lots of great still photographs throughout the trip.
Nowhere near as good as this. Mm.
What, the crab they have here?
Yeah. Crab here.
Good flavor. Mm. Have to have crab at Tamarind.
Like a good crab minister. I know, that's what I was telling you.
Oh, so good. It's my favorite thing, of crab claws.
Crab claws, man.
They're not big like they used to be. They're about that size
now. And then we're
hitting
the casino. Are you a gambler?
No.
Restaurant.
He's a wise man if he's not a gambler.
It's still nice to go up there.
No. But I'll show you a few card tricks.
Oh, yeah. Hey, don't forget your magic tricks. I forgot about that.
I got a few card tricks I can show you.
Yeah.
And magic, too, right?
Mm-hmm.
Is it all card-based?
A lot of it's card-based.
The locals will dig that stuff.
I should have brought my rope trick to show these guys. They used to working with ropes.
I'm here with Barry Konecki.
Yeah, no, that goes down a tree over
his
here.
His stepfather, magic. Robin. And his
Did you read
mom?
That email from Jennifer about Heather's brother?
Yeah.
We got the pirates coming.
Pirates? Somalis are coming.
Here come the Somalis.
Well, they're dragging two boats.
That's the mothership with the two skips.
You're going to see sunset just now.
Quite nice, huh?
Time for a drink now. It's now a real drink time, not a drink.
After relaxing in Khalifi for 10 days, working on some architectural projects, we finally decide to head into Tsavo West National Park. This is our transport. Seems everybody's got a couple of these laying around. This is a typical mud hut structure that you see all over in Kenya. Sticks and mud. Here we are at the entrance to the park. And the park is just loaded with wildlife. It's absolutely gorgeous, unbelievable.
You can hear their ivory knocking together.
Watching these elephants do their little dance here. Incredibly exciting to watch. We saw herd after herd of elephant in Tsavo. These are just the most unbelievable creatures. They are so intelligent. Que ille te que tiene merino mi oro. here it looks like they caught a little scent of me. Got their noses up in the air. And with this guy, I think I got a little too close. You can tell when they put their ears forward like that. They're ready to charge. This is a dried riverbed. Shaky video here. Tried to correct it, which it did somewhat, but shooting a very long lens handheld here. Amazing watching these giraffes interact with each other. Some elephants catching some shade in the noonday sun. These acacias provide shade and habitat for numerous creatures in Tsavo. We had a great vantage point up on a hill overlooking this waterhole. One herd after another coming in, taking turns at the waterhole. Some buffalo in the background that were pushed out of the hole when the herds came in. What a great way to spend the day. Here I got a little closer, moving down the hill. With some incredible close-up shots. I think one thing that people don't realize about African elephants is that they are way bigger than the circus elephants. The elephants that you see in the circus are Indian elephants, which are much smaller. When you see these African elephants for the first time, they are just gigantic, especially the bull elephants. What's a trip to Africa without a baboon or a herd of them? This is on top of Lion's Rock. We were very careful to scout the area before we got out of the vehicles.
Okay, next
item. A favorite place for the lions of Tsavo to stake out the surrounding area.
There's one drop off there, I don't think.
Still shots. Some different effects applied to the stills. Big bull that just took a bath and now he's scratching his butt on a termite mound. And